Okay guys, walking along and I've just spotted a Bronze Age axe on the surface, which is absolutely unbelievable. It's just laying there. Look at that. Bronze Age axe on the surface, is socketed. It's the first complete socketed axe I've ever had. I've moved a few feet away from where I had that axe on the surface. Got a signal. I thought it was going to be a tin can. It was coming in 27 and one scoop out. I can see, I don't know if you can see just there, but there is another Bronze Age axe. What is the chances of that? I think there's a very good chance that this is going to be something special. But there it is. Absolutely immaculate patterned Bronze Age axe. Now I've had these in the past, but they've always been broken. I mean, I've had the loops and bits of the rim. I've had the edges, lots of edges, but it's my ambition to get a Bronze Age axe, a socketed axe, and now I've got two. Right, brilliant. I wonder how many. Andy, a second one, another axe. Okay, I've got another signal here. It's not as high as the other one, actually. 24-25, so it's possibly good. Out of the hole. Oh my god, there's another axe. Okay, this is a Palstave axe. So that's the first Palstave. There's signals now all around us. Andy's come.
Got 25 over here.
Well, that's what this was. So there it is, look at that. Let's get it in the sunlight. Absolutely beautiful. So that's axe number three. Amazing, this is gonna be one hell of a day. So what you got then, Andy?
Oh,
so you got one as well. Hey, look at that, it's two. Two, they're as rare as hen's teeth. So they're all over the place. I think we'll carry on and see what we got. Now I'm running out of GoPro battery. I didn't charge it up, so anyway, let's carry on and see what else we can find. They're coming out thick and fast now. We've got signals really over the whole area. Now there's a very slight dip in the field and that's where they're all coming from, but they seem to be spaced out a lot, so we're going to continue taking them out of the topsoil. It's very clay soil. I don't think most of them just seem to be on the surface. I mean, one of these, I just literally kicked the soil and it was there. Okay, but there you go. That one's been hit by the plough a bit. They've all been obviously knocked around a bit, but they've still got remarkable edges on them. Okay, here's an interesting one. It's a big lump of bronze. I think this is what they call a bun ingot. Bronze Age. Came in very, very high signal, 33. Didn't sound like any of the axes. All the axes are coming like 25 up to about 29, and this was 33. So so interesting. It looks like it's probably a hoard, but what's weird is that although we got lots and lots of signals around, there doesn't seem to be a concentration yet. So I don't know, it might be that these have been dumped here. Now there is a hedge. There is a hedge right next to us. And obviously there'll be a ditch running there. So I'm wondering now if this has been all dug out of that hedge and spread on this field. Because usually with Bronze Age, you'd expect to be a big concentration, but they're all sort of scattered around this slight depression in the field. There's a slight depression and they all seem to be there. Okay, but yeah, still very exciting stuff, but I'm wondering if there's going to be more in that hedge. Anyway, more soon. Okay, there's two more, so we're getting to start mounting up now. Again, still, we're never quite sure. We think that we've got them all, and we move out a bit further, and we find more. So they're scattered over. You've got to see, Andy's picking them up as well. He's got a couple more. What are they? Socketed? Yeah, they seem to be mainly socketed at the moment. Yeah, two more. So, coming up. So, how many we got now? We got 2, 4, 7, 8, 9. Is that 12? 13 unlucky for Sam, and a couple of these ingots. Okay, but there's still lots and lots of signals out here. You know what? That's too deep to do. I'll leave that. I don't want to get into the archaeology. If there's archaeology on this site, it's worth leaving it for the experts. It's obviously very, very deep. Even though the probe was giving me this target, it still sounds very deep on the machine. So we're going to leave that one. This could be a small bit of that bun. The only other thing that we've been finding are bits of lead and musket balls. So, right, and it's a bullet. I thought it was a bit weird, so just a bullet this time. Okay guys, this is crazy stuff. Here's what we found. It's getting a bit hard now. I think Andy's still digging over there, but it's been a few minutes since the last one was found. It is a massive hoard. I'm lost for words. It's just truly amazing how many there were in the ground, and there's no broken ones. There's no sort of broken pieces. The only sort of hoard-like material are these bits of bun ingot. But apart from that, all the axes were probably serviceable actually when they went into the ground. There's a few damaged ones. I mean, the plough's given that one a bit of a whack, putting it to the surface, and there's a few crushed, obviously where the tractors have gone over them, but generally they're in very good condition. Few obviously have broken in antiquity. I mean, there's chips. Now, we find these chips when we're detecting anyway, so it's nice to actually see that they were still valued once they came off, and they were obviously you know, deposited because they still had a value. But they are amazing stuff. And as I say, there's some really, really nice decorated ones. It's been amazing how many have just been laying on the surface. I mean, that was just laying again on the surface. Incredible. So anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this. My GoPro is about to give up. This is the last axe found. Andy got a deep signal. He thought it was a deep signal. It wasn't very deep, but it was only 21, target ID of 21, and it's this tiny little axe, a lot smaller than all the others. Okay, here's the one that the farmer found at the other end of the field. Now, it might not be one of the hoard. You can see it's been scraped along the soil, and there you can see where it's obviously been hit by something, probably a subsoiler. And it's then been pushed through. It could be from the hoard. It might be completely just a coincidence. The patina does look a little bit different to everything else, but this is the one that the farmer picked up. Loads and loads of axes, 47 all in all, and 5 lumps of bronze, which is the bronze bun. Okay, so there you go. A brilliant day's detecting. An ambition of mine was to find a socketed axe, and now a whole hoard of them.